So friends, today I will be discussing the topic electrical heating, okay? Before getting into the topic, just tell me that in today's world, heat is one of the most basic or the most common requirement, okay? Ranging from its domestic purpose which includes cooking or heating, or industrial purpose, which can include melting of metals, hardening and tempering, case hardening, drying and welding. Clear? So these are the use of heating. And what are the ways this heat can be achieved? By burning fossil fuel or any source of combustion. But instead of that, what we will do? We will use electrical heating. Or basically we will discuss about that, okay? So what are the advantages? The first advantage is cheap. This electrical heating system, the oven or the coil, is very cost effective. And maintenance and running cost both are very low. Clear? Second is that it is clean. Electrical heating produces no ash, which is generated if coal or any other source of combustion was used. Clear? It is clean in nature. Third, hygienic. No flue gases are generated. No gases which are harmful, which would have been generated if that fossil fuel was used, no such gases are generated. So it is hygienic in nature. Fourth is efficient. Electrical heating has a very high efficiency percentage. Clear? Safe. Electrical heating is very safe because it is very easy to control. Just a bit of awareness, if followed, then electrical heating is a very safe heating method. Arrangements are simple. Accuracy. The exact amount of heat delivered you come to know. That what is the exact amount of heat you are delivering. Clear? So the accuracy is also good. The temperature is quite reliable. In other sources, the chances of fluctuations are very high. But in this case, the temperature is very reliable. Clear? Next point is The temperature provided is uniform. Okay. So these are the advantages. Requirement of materials used for heating. So, first point, they should have high resistivity. Clear? They should have high melting point. Low temperature coefficient. Can withstand the temperature without getting oxidized. Now this is a very important point. Fourth point is a very important point, because at higher temperature the chances of oxidation are even higher. Okay. So the requirement of such material is there which do not get easily oxidized at that temperature. Okay. Now temperature control method. The heat produced in the oven, what is the formula of heat? Heat is a form of energy. Energy, how it is indicated? V is equal to I, R, I into V. So I square R, clear? So I square R, clear? Or V square by R. So by these two formula you can know the amount of heat which is generated and what are the method of temperature control. Now the point I'll be discussing is the methods of temperature control used. Clear? So, the first method is by using variable number of heating element. Suppose if multiple number of heating elements are working, then by controlling that or controlling the number that will be working, number of heating element out of the total present that is working, the heat can be controlled. The next method is by changing the connection. Either all elements are in series or in parallel or combination of both in star or delta. Here, just by changing it by star or delta, the total output can be changed, clear? The total heat generated, that can be changed because that will change the amount of current flowing, the voltage across or the equivalent resistance, everything is changed. So that will also change the temperature. The third is, by adding external resistance, this will cause a reduced current flow because V is equal to IR. For a constant voltage, when you increase the resistance, the current value will decrease. So this decrease in current value will cause I square R thing will have a lower value. So this means the amount of heat generated is also less. The next method is by varying transformer tapping. For that, what will happen? When transformer tapping is changed, then it will actually directly affect the voltage, okay? That V value will change. Now if R is constant, if V reduces, so I will also reduce, that is quite obvious. So again I square R will be less. So these are the methods used for temperature control. Okay, thank you.